Good Thursday morning, Spartans, and welcome to Timeline. I'm Carissa Steele.
And I'm Christian Akridge. Thank you for tuning in. So, Chris, with all the new changes that are happening around campus this semester, which one are you most excited for?
I've really enjoyed the changes in the dining hall, and I'm really excited to see what they do next.
I agree. I'm pretty excited, too.
Vaccines will soon be available on MBU campus. The Jefferson County Department of Health has partnered up with MBU to hold a vaccine drive on campus on September 16th.
And the second injections will be available on October 7th. Students over 18 years old and in need of their first, second, or booster injection can register for vaccination appointments. Health insurance will not be required, however, because the vaccination is free.
The clinic will be available September 16th and October 7th from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. on both dates. MBU highly encourages the staff, faculty, and students to become vaccinated against COVID-19.
Career Week is coming up from September 20th to September 24th. The week will be full of prizes and fun, and those that attend 5 out of 9 events will be entered in a raffle to win a pair of AirPod Pros.
These events help students to start thinking about their career now and encourage students to prepare for the upcoming School of Business Virtual Career and Internship Fair on September 29th.
Students may register for all events through Handshake. Don't wait to think about your career until you cross the stage of graduation. Start thinking about your next steps now. Before we move on, Carissa, how was your summer?
It was really fun. I was able to work and I also was able to hang out with all my friends.
Very nice. Very nice. Well, let's see what our fellow Spartans did this summer.
Did you watch the Olympics this year?
I did.
Pretty even at the moment. Curly going well. Lamont Jacobs on the far side, and the Italian has done it. That is absolutely incredible.
What sport did you find entertaining this year?
I personally thought that track and field, specifically the 100, 200 meter dash this year was very entertaining.
You were good in this sport and you were invited into an Olympics, what sport would that be?
Personally, I would want to do the 400 meters. I think that's really good, fun. I like to watch that, it's very entertaining.
I felt basketball to be the most interesting just because a lot of the USA's best basketball players, like best to ever be known, didn't even participate. LeBron James, Stephen Curry, guys like that weren't going. So you had some guys just on the come up of starting go by themselves, and you had to come up with a completely different team than what you had in the past.
So if you were invited to the Olympics and you were good at that sport, what would it be?
It would be that basketball. I'd be on that team, a star player.
If you are a musician looking for a place to perform, or if you have some original music or poetry that you would like to share, you should consider Student Activities Open Mic Night.
This Thursday, September 16th at 7 p.m. in the Perk, Student Activities is hosting an open mic night. This will be a fun, family-friendly event where you can come and see your friends perform, so be sure to stop in and check it out. If you're not too busy this week or in need of a distraction from studying,
you can enjoy Open Gym on September 24th. The gym will be open at 8 p.m. and will include board games, food, video games, and much more. However, you must have a valid student ID to participate. If you need access to a more positive streaming service, maybe you should consider subscribing to Right Now Media.
Right Now Media is a streaming library of Bible study videos that inspires faith, devotion, and inspiration every day of the week.
Sign up today using your MBU email to get access to a whole library of Christian resources. Just visit the link on the screen.
Here's Hannah with sports.
Hello, my people. I'm Hannah Leahy, and I'm back and ready to bring you the latest and greatest in the world of Spartan sports. To start, wow, our women's volleyball team, though. Y'all already know how great they are, but their results just keep reminding us. This week, they actually swept all AMC Player of the Week categories, with Giovanna Tapigliani as Attacker of the Week, Manuela Vargas as Setter of the Week, and Ariana Macias as Defender of the Week. After winning all the games in last week's Spartan Invitational, they now have one more non-con opponent to face before kicking off conference play against William Woods in exactly 1 week from today. We are so proud of you girls. Keep it up. The men's soccer team had their first win of the season on Monday night with an outstanding 5-4 overtime victory against the Firehawks from University of Tennessee Southern. A shot attempt 4 minutes into overtime from senior forward Cullen Barr ricocheted off the bottom left post, and sophomore Grant Strausser was there to swoop in and finish with ease, bringing the boys to sweet, sweet, sweet victory. Congrats, y'all. We go again Saturday with a trip to Indiana against Taylor University. Women's soccer also saw themselves represented in the weekly AMC Awards thanks to senior center back Maddie Gentry winning AMC Defensive Player of the Week. Gentry came up big in a 2-1 win against Waldorf University, scoring her first goal as a Spartan and holding it down with many great defensive moments. She also played a huge role in a 1-0 win over Evangel last week, anchoring the back line with her center back counterpart, sophomore Jamie Toisch. Be sure to check these two and the rest of women's soccer out this Saturday at home against Baker University at 6 p.m. Football had a bye week last week, so they still sit at 2-0 for the first time ever in program history. They will be back in action this weekend for a Saturday game at noon against Madonna University. Make sure to bring your friends and get ready to get loud for your Spartans. Good luck, boys. That's all I have for this week, but as always, it has been a privilege to celebrate our awesome teams here at MBU. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Hannah. Don't forget, it is a requirement to use your Spartan Safe app every day you're here on campus to keep you and others safe.
Right, and be sure to answer all the questions to get your green badge. Now, if you do have any questions about the MBU COVID protocol, please visit the link on the screen. That's all for this week's Timeline Update in the News.
For more stories like these from around the MBU community, visit MBU Timeline at the link on your screen. Thank you for watching, and we will see you next week.